That's it right there.
I'm the head football coach at Benton Harbor High School, Benton Harbor, Michigan.
Here we go, Ryan.
I went into retirement and kind of bored, and my wife told me, she said, I think you're a little bit bored, and why don't you go coach? And I said, I don't know about that. And then she brought up Benton Harbor.
Here we go.
Every day he started asking me, what are we going to do today? And I said, Elliot, I'm not your social director. I said, go to Benton Harbor. They need somebody. And so that's how it all started.
Go!
Elliot Uzelac is a decorated football coach. He was the MAC Football Coach of the Year at Western in 1976 and coached under Bo Schembechler at Michigan. More recently, he coached at St. Joseph High School and then got back into the game with a program that hadn't won a game in two seasons.
I tell people the first day of practice looked like the movie The Longest Yard. It was unbelievable. Balls were going into the woods. I don't know how many footballs I lost the first day. And then kids were running into each other. Some kid ran the fence, and I don't know how he did that because the fence is way far away.
You know what's coming.
The team had lost 68 of its last 72 games with a 19-game losing streak.
We used to fight each other, locker room, games, halftime.
Start tutoring them 4 days a week, and so we're doing everything we can to change their lives around. To me, this is more than coaching. This is a total cultural change, and at my age, I am thrilled to be able to help young men like this to get that done.
The practice, play style is like, before that, a lot of people used to just play around and practice, and we didn't get much done.
We just didn't work hard or nothing. He made us work. Like, as soon as we got into practice the first day, the weight room, just, oh my God, so much work.
He make us practice hard. He make us work together and, like, you know, like, work as a team.
Because at first everybody like, man, we tired, we can't do all this, but then we get on the field and do what he say do, pays off.
Well, you can't succeed in life without hard work. I mean, I don't see how you can't. I mean, that's just the way I was brought up. That's everybody I worked for was that way. And I just think that if you put in a lot of hard work, results will come.
We feed them every Friday. So we make sure that they have meat, chicken usually, pasta, a vegetable, sometimes a salad, fresh fruit cut up, and great desserts.
A lot of our football players are the breadwinners in the family. They're supplementing an income in the family. How do you go to practice and work? We didn't have anything. You know, I remember I taped one kid's ankle and I looked at him and I said, good luck.
Things changed, spirit changed, and so did the product on the field. They had their first win in 21 games, then another, and another.
It feels so good when you look up to the crowd, especially when you win in the game, see your family, friends, all the people out there supporting you.
They did not have a winning season since 89. Never in the history of school have been to the playoffs. They never won a playoff game.
Suddenly, the team qualified for the playoffs.
He was a nobody to us at first. Now what is he? Everything.
I see a lot of smiles in the hallway. I love to see our kids smile. I love them. In my heart, I think they're starting to believe that they are important. Without self-esteem, without any hope, as you say, you can't succeed in life. You're going to make bad mistakes.
This was a gift from God. He gifted us. Every day we're grateful and thankful.
You know, we're here for a lot of reasons, not just the wins and losses on the scoreboard. I mean, we're working for a total cultural change. I want them to take away some life lessons, and that's very simply, you got to have discipline, you got to work hard, and you got to be honest with yourself. You know, you got to be honest with yourself as far as what you're capable of doing and not doing. But you still have to dream, but you have to work upon those dreams. I want them to dream. I want them to have thoughts and dreams that, hey, I could be something special. But they have to learn, they have to work very hard to do that.
Oh, they offered him a salary. He turned it down. He's a volunteer.
You guys gave a great effort based on what we had. So I'm proud of you. I'm very proud of you. You worked hard and we got good things done.
Get ready to go. On three, let's go. Tiger pride, Jeremy. What are we talking about?
Tiger pride!
What are we talking about?
Tiger pride!
One, two, three!
Tiger pride!